feel a soul in it. How many spiritual people in the room tonight? I can't hear y'all. How many spiritual people in the room tonight?
Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for this time of studying and sharing. We thank you for who you've been to us and who you're going to be and who you'll always be. God, we just thank you for an opportunity to grow in grace and in love through your word, through your son, Jesus. So as we go into today's devotional, we ask that you would speak to our hearts, God. Open up our minds and our understanding. Give us what you will have us to know so that we can apply it to our hearts and to our lives. God, we thank you that you are changing us from the inside out and that you are giving us a desire to be better, to love you and to love your people. We dedicate this time to you and we thank you in advance. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, believers in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ must not show favoritism. Suppose someone comes into your meeting wearing a gold ring and fine clothes, and a poor person in filthy old clothes also comes in. If you show special attention to the one wearing fine clothes and say, "Here's a good seat for you," but say to the one who is poor,
"You, stand there, or sit on the floor by my feet."
Have you not discriminated among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my dear brothers and sisters. Has not God chosen these who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and to inherit the kingdom he promised those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor. Is it not the rich who are exploiting you? Are they not the ones who are dragging you into court? Are they not the ones who are blaspheming the noble name of him to whom you belong? If you really keep the royal law found in Scripture, love your neighbor as yourself, you are doing right. But if you show favoritism, you sin and are convicted by the law as lawbreakers. For whoever keeps the whole law and yet stumbles at just one point is guilty of breaking all of it. For he who said, "You shall not commit adultery," also said, "You shall not murder." If you do not commit adultery, but do commit murder, you have become a lawbreaker. Speak and act as those who are going to be judged by the law that gives freedom, because judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone who has not been merciful. Mercy triumphs over judgment. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if people claim to have faith but have no deeds? Can such faith save them? Suppose a brother or sister is without clothes and daily food. If one of you says to them,
"Go in peace, keep warm and well fed,"
but does nothing about their physical needs, what good is it? In the same way, faith by itself, if it is not accompanied by action, is dead. But someone will say,
"You have faith, I have deeds."
Show me your faith without deeds, and I will show you my faith by what I do. You believe that there is one God. Good. Even the demons believe that and shudder. You foolish person, do you want evidence that faith without deeds is useless? Was not our father Abraham considered righteous for what he did when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that his faith and his actions were working together, and his faith was made complete by what he did. And the scripture was fulfilled that says, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. And he was called God's friend. You see that people are justified by what they do, and not by faith alone. In the same way, was not even Rahab the prostitute considered righteous for what she did when she gave lodging to the spies and sent them off in a different direction? As the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without deeds is dead.
Hit me!
Hey. If you don't mind, can I be far from perfect? Just can I be me? Do you have time to see what a work in progress really means? Spend many a night on my knees, 'cause that's the key for me to be free. A thousand tears, a million no's, I don't.
There's four kinds of people.
For everything you've done for me.
Oh. Or four attitudes. Somebody in here is soil number one. Somebody in here is soil number two. Somebody's here soil number three. And somebody's soil number four. And here's what I know. There are less soil fours than there are one, twos, and threes. Listen, every church has plenty of one, two, three soils. And only a fourth of the total soil that shows up is soil four. Which one are you? Now watch, everybody, I'm four. Right? Ooh, let's see about that. Okay? Here we go. Here's the key. The key to any good crop is the soil. Let that sink in. The key to any good crop is the soil. If you've ever done any gardening or anything like that, you know that. You know that. You know the key to a good crop is the soil in which you plant stuff. The soil is key to how well the crop is. In fact, on letter A, the soil is the determining factor of the size and richness of any crop. It's the soil. You got to understand, it's not the seed. The seed is designed to do whatever the seed is designed to do. If you plant an apple seed, it's going to become an apple tree. But it will not become an apple tree if it's not planted in good soil. Are you with me? Or it will become an apple tree that is a dwarf of what it should be because the soil hasn't given it what it needs in order to grow and bloom and blossom to become all that it should be. So the seed, you don't need a better seed. You need better soil. So soil preparation is key to what you do with seeds that are planted. Which means this, you should never just show up at church. Listen. You gotta prepare. What would your spiritual life be like if you prepared your heart the way you prepared your body? Ooh, y'all missed that one. Ain't nobody coming here today without washing. Hopefully. Ain't nobody came in here without brushing their teeth. Hopefully. Right? Why? Because if you came in here without washing or brushing your teeth, you'd be offensive. Okay. How many of you have ever had an offensive Christian say something, do something to you? Let me tell you why. Because they didn't prepare. So when we come to God, when we come and it's time to get God's word, listen, I got to prepare my mind. Because if my mind is not prepared, oh, listen, ain't no telling what soil I'm gonna be today. It just ain't no telling, right? So watch this. Here, now, step back. I need you to get the big picture. Here we go. Here's what's happening. So farmer goes out trying to get him a crop. So your boy takes his seed. And you got to remember, in a garden, you have on this side, you have, an area where plants are going to grow. On that side, area where plants are going to grow. And right down the middle is the path that you walk on while you sow your seed. Right? Now, you got to understand. So he's just sowing seed. I'm going to jump down, turn around, and pick a bill of cotton. I'm going to jump down, turn around, and pick a bill of day. He just sowing seed. No work, ain't nothing but a little seed. And I'm a little seed. That's all it is. Just a little bit of seed. Are y'all with me? So now watch this. What do you notice about the seeds I have just sown? They're everywhere. Even on the path that I'm walking on. Are you with me? Now, how much time I got? None. Jesus. Why y'all make me run out of time? Okay, so here's what I need for you to do. I need for you to remember this mess. Help me clean it up. Right? Come back next week and we will pick up right from here because we're about to approach the first kind of mind. Are y'all with me? Okay, all right, here we go. Y'all should have told me I had no time if I threw all these seeds down here.
Don't touch me.
Miss Tan says, stop laughing and pray. Just, we gotta clean up these seeds. Okay, listen, here we go. Let's pray. God in heaven, we thank you for all that we have seen and heard today. Father, even as we have not been able to get through the complete message, Lord, there has been enough word given to touch, challenge, and change somebody's life and situation. And I pray that you would take what has been said, translate it into what everyone needs, so that when we leave here, we make decisions based on new information and not old practices. Father, change us. Mold us, shape us, transform us into who you want us to be. And God, we thank you for speaking. And we apologize for not always tuning in. But we thank you for being patient and keep and continuing to speak, even though sometimes we miss you. So Father, our ears are open, our eyes are wide, our hearts are big. Because God, what we know is that there's no way for us to be successful in anything we do if we have not first heard from you. So God, keep speaking. And help us, God help us, to tune in. Just like music.